In contemporary societies, we have something of a different pattern, because the average age of menstruation for girls has declined. Right now, the average is about 12 years of age, and this age has been going down over the past 150 years or so. This is sometimes called the secular trend. A secular trend is when something shows a long-term linear trend in a single direction over time. In this case, it refers to the secular trend in the age of menarche. You can see here that this is the girl's first year of menstruation, ages and years. This is the year that the data were collected. You can see a very clear downward trend, where in 1860, the average age of menstruation was between 15 and 16 years. From then on, the average age of menarche decreases. Some people suggest that this is due to improved nutrition and improved health care, which results in better growth and girls mature earlier, reaching their first menstruation at earlier ages. While the average age of menstruation has gone down, the average age of first marriage is going up. In Australia, in 1974, the average age of first marriage for women was around 21, and for men it was 23. But in 2014, the average age for women is about 28 years, and for men it was about 30. So for both men and women, the age of first marriage has increased about 7 years since the mid-1970s. So what we get in contemporary societies is this much broader spread from the onset of puberty to the part of your life where you actually take on all those adult responsibilities. In terms of identity formation, in contemporary societies, all of these adult roles, all of these things that you're supposed to be heading towards, marriage, careers, having homes, having children, now happen about a decade after the onset of puberty. For contemporary societies, these events look very different from those of traditional societies. They're almost happening in a different phase of life. Adolescence has gone from a 2 or 4 year phase in life to about 8 to 15 years. There are pros and cons to these changes. One of the pros of this expanded adolescence is that it gives adolescents a whole bunch of time to think about really deep questions, like who am I, what do I want to be, who do I want to love, and what do I believe in? Adolescents have a lot more time and freedom before taking on adult responsibilities than they used to. Some people suggested that this has been pretty fundamental in changing our cultures over time. One of the cons, people have suggested at least, involves that delay in social responsibility. People are afraid that young people will never move out of their parents' house. But when it's all said and done, at least from a cultural perspective, probably the pros outweigh the cons.